This is Staff Sergeant Alvin Josephi, Jr., a United States Marine Corps combat correspondent speaking from Iwo Jima. An attack is underway, and so far this morning, in a couple of hours, they have gone approximately 500 yards through the most difficult kind of terrain. This island is studded with pillboxes, and they have already passed through several lanes of them and have passed over the volcanic ash, the terrible yellow, craggy, rocky, lifeless soil of this part of the island. Whoops, some bullets are whistling past us. We are in the open. Japanese mortars and also small arm fire are occasionally dropping around us.
The Battle of Iwo Jima took place on the Iwo Jima Islands in the Pacific Ocean, 575 miles from Japan, starting on February 19th. At this time, the Japanese had control of the island and turned it into a fortress. The battle started months in advance with bombing raids by the Navy and Air Force. These battles were a major part of the Pacific battles of World War II. In this battle, U.S. Marines were taken by the Navy to the islands where they began their amphibious invasion. The Navy had a total of 880 ships that were sent to the island. This is the largest number of ships that was sent to any specific island at one time during this war. This composed of over 69,000 troops. The troops were held on the beach for a while because of cover fire from the Japanese. Then they encountered many troops stationed further in the island, which were taken care of with flamethrowers. Flamethrowers were also used to demolish most of the forest on the island for the search for Japanese military. From the shoreline, they advanced to the major landmark of the island, the Suribachi Mountain. On the way to the mountain, many people died. In this mountain, the Japanese had carved many tunnels and gunning points so that they were well defended and could get a good shot on American troops going up the island. The Japanese had 21,060 troops. In this battle had some of the first kamikaze raids on the U.S. fleet while they were helping the Marines by laying cover fire on the mainland. This obviously was not successful because we won the battle. At the end of this battle, when we had conquered the island, Marine troops did the flag raising on the top of the mountain. This caused possibly one of the greatest military pictures in our country's history, which was actually a fake. The real flag raising was a much different picture. In conclusion, the Battle of Iwo Jima was a very deadly battle. Many people died or were injured. The Navy's fleet was slowed down, but they were still able to fight their way to the Japanese mainland. At the end of this battle, we had control of two airstrips that were going to help us with the invasion of the Japanese mainland and the volcanic island. The Medal of Honor was given to 27 Marines for their heroic efforts during the battle. There have been many movies about the events that happened on the islands. Most famous could be Sands of Iwo Jima featuring John Wayne. As a result of the battle, 6,000 men were killed and 17,000 more were injured. There was a reunion for the soldiers who survived the war and more specifically the battle. This is the 26th year running for this reunion.
And there is quite a bit of fire going on around here. The roar you hear in the background, our planes are coming from our own planes that are assisting the infantry just up ahead of us. Tremendously well-fortified island. I compare it to the Siegfried Line or one of those fortified lines in Europe, except that this is the entire island studded with such a line. Well, this is a moment at Iwo Jima. It is what the men are living under in their foxholes here. When you go to bed in your foxhole at night, you lie awake usually for hours listening to this. This is Staff Sergeant Alvin Jones. Iwo Century Jr., concluding this broadcast from Iwo Jima.